Hi, I'm going to show you the Radleys Reactor-Ready Pilot jacketed lab reactor system, which replaces multiple reactor setups with a single universal pilot scale system that allows you to swap vessels in one framework quickly and easily. We have now expanded our range of vessels to include a 30-litre and a 35-litre vessel, so now we do 5, 10, 15, 20, 30 and 35-litre vessels. So in order to use the 30 and 35-litre vessels, you'll need the bottom support, which is compatible with both new and existing reactor-ready pilot systems. So our framework is called the Reactor-Ready Pilot Core. You can see it's quite sturdy and stable and features these brace bars, which add additional cross bracing to the system when the vessel is loaded in. Our framework is quite open from the front, so it means that you have easy access to the bottom outlet valve in order to drain your vessel contents after your reaction. All our vessels have the same size DN200 flange and locate into the frame with this vessel collar, eliminating the need for any adapters when swapping between vessels of different sizes. So now I'll show you how easy it is to swap from the 5-litre vessel we have in the frame at the minute to the new 30-litre vessel. So first, we're going to lift the overhead stirrer up using the I-beam, which takes the weight of the overhead stirrer. Then we can secure it using the two safety collars. Now you can see that the overhead stirrer is not connected directly to the impeller. Instead, we have a patented drop-in coupling which sits inside the stirrer guide. Now this ensures that the weight of the overhead stirrer is not transferred through to the lid of the vessel and minimizes the risk of the lid breaking due to stirrer misalignment. So the next step will be to drain the thermal fluid from the vessel. Now with our system, this can be easily done using the manifolds. So the top manifold has an air vent on it and the lower manifold has a drain valve with a hose bar that you can attach tubing to for draining the thermal fluid into an external container. The manifolds also support the weight of the hoses from the circulator, as these can be quite heavy depending on how long and well insulated they are. Our manifolds also have M30 connections, which are wide bore and match the connections on most circulators appropriate for pilot sized vessels. Now we can disconnect the vessel to manifold hoses. So these also have wide bore connections, meaning that there's good flow of the thermal fluid around the jacket of the vessel. The connections on these hoses are made of PEEK, which is a fluoropolymer, meaning it's much less likely to damage or chip the glass vessel when you're taking them off and putting them on. There's no tools required to do this. This can all be done up hand tight. So now that we've drained the thermal fluid from the system, we're free to remove the vessel from the frame. So I'll start by removing the temperature probe, which is the PT100. And I can then undo the quick clamp, which allows me to remove the lid from the vessel. Now we have both 6 and 7 bore glass lids, which have a variety of different size rotovis connections on them for attaching accessories such as condensers and gas bubblers. Both the lid and the vessel have flat flanges with an FEP encapsulated silicone O-ring in between them for optimal sealing. I can now remove the impeller from the lid by loosening this metal cap. And we'll replace it with the impeller for the 30-litre vessel. Now, our stirrer guides have an extended design which reduces whipping of the impeller as well as reducing the risk of PTFE shedding from the impeller into the vessel. So now, I can remove the vessel from the frame and we'll just put it to one side. So now we can load our 30-litre vessel onto the frame. For both the 30 and 35-litre vessels, you'll need to raise the bottom support up to the vessel, which you can do easily by loosening these securing knobs using one hand. Raise it till it touches the bottom of the vessel and then secure them again. So now we can replace the O-ring connects the lid. Now, we also do a range of PTFE lids with customizable ports for PAT probes, but we'll replace the glass lid. And secure the clamp. Get the temperature probe. Finally, reconnect all vessel to manifold hoses. And our system is ready to use. We've also got a range of glassware accessories for Reactor-Ready Pilot, including new ball joints and condensers and adapters for easy alignment on the lid. If you need to perform distillations and solvent swaps, we have reflux divider kits which allow condensed vapors to be diverted into a separate receiving vessel. You can also automate your reactor using our AVA Lab control software, which allows you to data log and automate all periphery devices connected to your reactor, such as the circulator, overhead stirrer, as well as gravimetric additions modules for the liquid dosing. If you want to find out more about Reactor-Ready Pilot or AVA Lab control software, head over to our website and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more videos like this in the future.